Hello everyone, I am Professor Aishwarya. I am going to teach about module number 3, support reaction. So in the earlier videos we have seen about types of beams and types of hooks. So now we are going to see about the types of supports, right? So everywhere in the world or in the building where we reside, we can see there are varying types. So we cannot sustain without a support, isn't it? So for example, here you can see there is a beam, okay, or the pier. Here you can see in this beam, that is in this pillar, one beam is resting over it, right? So in the, when coming to structural analysis, we will be saying everything as a beam only, right? Actually this is a column and this one is a beam, right? So here you can see some support is being laid for this beam. Likewise, this is one type of support. So we have varying supports. Right. So we shall see one by one in this lecture video. The first type of support is simply support. So in the simply support, there is no connection between the beam and the support. All this type of support only it causes only a vertical reaction. Simply support means over the beam only the over the column only a beam will be rested, and only one vertical reaction you can see over the support. And the next one is a fixed end support. A beam is completely fixed at the end of the wall or support, right? So this is called as a fixed support. Beam cannot rotate, and reactions may be, for a fixed support, the reaction may be vertical, horizontal, incline and moment. So a fixed support will produce, see, all the movements are restricted. So you can get one vertical support, one horizontal support, one incline support and one moment. The fixed end support will look like this, right? Next one is here, roller support. So here we have, whenever you see a support in the form of a roller, you can make it as a roller support. So in this type of roller support, rollers are placed below the beam and it can be slid over the rollers, right? Reaction will be perpendicular to the surface on which the rollers are supported. So guys, in the roller support, you will get only one vertical reaction. It is perpendicular and towards the beam. This type of support is normally provided at the end of the bridges, right? Due to the braking forces of vehicles and the temperature forces, bridge slab can slide over the roller support and damage to bridge pier can be avoided. So why this roller support is needed? Because in the bridge we can see there are lot of vehicles, and in the bridge slab it will slide over one support to another support. In order to avoid that, only this roller support has been provided in the bridges, okay? Now the next one is a hinged support. A very good example for a hinged support is a door, okay, where we can see the hinges at the end. So in the hinged support, beams and the supports are connected by the hinge. Beam can rotate about the hinge. Reactions may be a vertical or horizontal or inclined for the hinged support. So for the hinged support, you will get one vertical support and one horizontal support, as like the pin support which you are seeing over here. So this is called hinged support or pinned support. So it will possess one vertical reaction and one horizontal reaction, right? So these are all the varying types of supports that I have been explaining you. And in the previous video, we were seeing about the types of loads and types of beams. So in the types of beams, you have seen simply supported beam. So here also simply support is there as well as a beam is there. Both are the meaning of same only, means the ends are supported. Simply it will be rested on any pillars or any beams. Okay, so for that a vertical reaction will be proposed. So and along with that, you would have seen some other beams like fixed beam or cantilever beam, overhanging beam, propped cantilever beam, right? So these are all one end fixed and one end hinged beam, like this and all. So in this hinge, the thing which is required is how they are being, see, why I am relating the types of beams along with the types of supports, means then after knowing the beams only, you can able to find that which, see, supports, based on the support only type of beam can be determined, isn't it? So fixed beam means it will be two ends fixed, that is fixed support at the two ends. Even the type of loading is not bothered. For example, the type of loading is like concentrator load, uniformly distributed load, uniformly varying load, that can be applied in any type of beams. But when coming to the supports, it is purely based on the support conditions, whichever has been processed in the types of support, whichever you are seeing, the same will be applied, and with respect to that only, types of beams has been determined. So guys, the questions like types of beams and types of loads and types of supports is going to be a very important for your university question paper, and based on the types of supports only, reactions will be determined. For example, simply support means it produces only one vertical reaction, but if it is a hinged support means it will produce one vertical reaction and one horizontal reaction. If it's a roller support means it produces only one vertical reaction. If it's a fixed support means it produces one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction, and also one moment, right? So this is how you need to categorize the reactions. When solving the numerical, you need to draw a FBD. In that FBD, you need to determine the types of support and you need to fix as such. For example, if it's a roller support, you have to fix a one vertical reaction. If it's a hinge support, you have to produce one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction, and one moment. That is purely based on the orientation of the supports, right? So guys, these are all the topics which has been involved in the module number 3, right? So you have to know about the types of beams, types of supports, and types of loads. So in the types of support, you have seen simply support, roller support, hinged support, and fixed support. So based on that, so many types of beams are there, guys. So thank you everyone. Thank you, and keep watching for the next lecture video. We'll meet you in the next lecture video. Thank you everyone.